Britain, any British people in the house, make some noise. Richard Branson, Michael Caine, anybody? A few. All right. Well, he's from the UK. Theresa May's here. I don't know if she's left, but so is he. Wow, I boo. Gee, come on. Show some love for Theresa May. And please, show some love for the very funny Johnny Darko.
Is this on? Okay. Hello. Hello. I was going to do a joke about me being from Donbay, but I think she's blown my cover. Fuck. I'm going to move. This is bizarre. It's like a block of Lego. Oh, God. 5 acts in. Can you hear me better now? I feel like a buskin. Go for a little. Do you want to bring some? No. You're in key. You can't see at the back, she's got a big hat, little head, big glove. I want to turn you into my own little travel frog. I just want to carry you around and give you treats and send you on trips. Hello, nice to meet you. Thanks for coming. Everyone, thanks for supporting local comedy. Thank you, give yourselves a big round of applause. It's my first show here, I've never been here before. And then I was at a point where everyone sort of sat down and we all had that sort of realisation of like, we've come to see comedy in a barn. Weird. We've got like seats here. No, if you look at this from above, it's like Michael J. Fox playing Tetris. It looks really, really weird. Absolutely bizarre space. And then I'm standing here now and I've got the lights in my eyes and I can't see you at the back, but I feel like I'm in one of those like commercials where they've got the model and all the lights. And she's all L'Oreal, I'm worthless. That's my absolute tagline. How are you doing? Having a good time? How you doing there, fella? Having a good time? You look well into this. Were you tricked into coming? Oh, did you choose that seat because you're more of an ass man? The best part about that is, before I was funny, I could never get laid. Look at that. Good to you all. Hello, for those of you who don't know me, my name's Johnny. Fun fact about me, I once made a voodoo doll of myself, gave it a blowjob to see what would happen. I got an erection, which was spooky. Was that magic I just did? I don't know. God sort of played a weird trick on me. He's sort of given me the head of Jason Statham. Body of Mrs. Doubtfire. Can I drive a car really fast, jump over the hood and kick someone in the head? No. Can I lick my own boob? I've been in China 5 years. Jennifer said if you go to Thailand, you're a paedophile. I think China's like failed paedophile. I want to do it, but I lack the current conviction. I just teach kids to dance. That's what I do. And the best part about being in China is the lies that foreigners tell themselves, right? It happened to me the other day. One of Jen's friends met me, and she was like, are you a teacher? And I was like, I do it on the side. I'm actually working on this podcast. It's going to blow your own mind. Wait until you read my travel blog. I've written this comedy. It should be on TV, right? It's about working in a training center and all of the wacky things we get up to. I met a girl recently and I said, what do you do for work? And she was like, well, you know, I'm an early years learning specialist with a focus on the acquisition of language through the medium of song and dance. Kindergarten teacher then. Land yourselves. Worst part about those lies, though, is that when you're a new foreigner, you believe the lies that other foreigners have told you, like the ones who have been here longer. Like, I've been here like 5 years, but if a guy's been here like 7 years, I'll be like, I'll believe that bullshit. I will, because he's like a more moderately powerful Pokemon. You know what I mean? I'm like Laowai, but he's like Laowai. I was on a train recently, this is actually a few years back, it wasn't recently, and I was coming back from with Alco. And like, the line 13 carriage really fucking stinks. It's like weed and BO. It's like being back home. Yeah, it's like weed and BO. And I remember this sort of like weird foreign guy was just staring at me. One of those ones where I was like, if he speaks to me in English, I'm speaking back in French. And so he looked at me and he was like, all right, mate. And I was like, oh, body.
parlez-vous français? It's like, oh, moi aussi, mon petit pain. Ah! Ah!
Ah! He sort of walked over to me from across the carriage, brother, and I was like, oh, for fuck's sake. And he just says this to me, right? Do you know they checked the seats in this carriage, right? They found 13 types of semen on each seat. And not all of it human. So I jumped out of the seat and I'm like, ah! I waited for the next stop. It wasn't even mine and I jumped off and I was like, I'm taking a taxi. I turned around and I just saw him smile at me as he sat on my seat. And then it hit me. I was like, I didn't question that. I believed the lie that Lawa had looked like he'd been in. Who are these cum counting scientists? Why is that a thing? Today's a special day. This, you've got barn, is this? This looks like a heater that's gone to a Halloween party. The bin bags up, I've got this monster from Scream. That's so terrible. Oh, what's this that's fallen down? Oh, it's only a flyer for a show that's coming up on Saturday for Turner Sparks, which you guys should all go to. Convenient. Convenient. You can scan the QR code off the floor at the end. Any friends? How long have you been here, buddy?
One and a half years.
1.5 years. What's the weirdest thing you've seen here?
Kids pissing on the street.
Kids pissing on the street. Yeah, no, I had an incident like that, funnily enough. I was in a restaurant for a friend's birthday, and there was like a little kid running around with the old cowboy chaps. You know, yeah, Free Willy going on. He was running around. He shouted something to his mum. She came over with a beer bottle and let him piss in it. And then he ran outside, and I saw her holding him over a trash can while he shit in it. And I was like, holy fuck. I didn't learn how to do that until college. Asian kids are smart. The Asian genius I've been hearing about. You guys know what the Asian pregnancy test is? You guys heard that? Pop a Rubik's Cube up, comes out solved, boom, she's preggo. And low at the back, it'll come to you guys. What's the Chinese for Rubik's Cube? Angeline looks really unimpressed. I liked your... You know like when people are like, oh, if you say like you hate gays, it's because you really love them. And I was like, listen to that, and I was like, you're like the inverse. You're like, I love Lawa's. I thought you really hate us. You're looking at me now like, I've never fit a Rubik's Cube in this. You're a serious feminist, or the F? Yeah, I saw that. So you think women and men are sort of equal? Yeah, no, it's good. You think women can do like anything men can do?
Technically.
How comes women haven't successfully oppressed an entire gender? What's clever about that joke? Because you don't know who side I'm on. Successfully oppressed an entire gender. We'll do politics and the feminine talk.
I'm oppressing you now.
You're oppressing me now.
Give me
no, you're oppressing me now. I want to show you something, right? Hairy as fuck. We'll talk later. My girlfriend's filming at the back, so she's probably doing some jokes about her to balance things out now. Yeah, I've been with my girlfriend a long time. I do this thing, a lot of guys do this with their girlfriends, it's sort of, it upsets your girlfriends. There's this thing that I do, and a lot of guys here do it too. It's called being happy in our own company. The men who aren't pussy with God. So I do this shit, I'm kind of just happy. I'm just sort of sitting down. Just doing nothing, and my girlfriend's like, oh man, he's happy in his own company. I should do something about that. I should ask him what he's thinking, because these thoughts belong to me now. But the worst part about it is like, I'm 31 and I'm immature. I don't want to share what I'm thinking with anyone. And sometimes I have to lie and say other women, because it's less embarrassing than what I'm thinking about. Here's one of the ones I had the other day, right? I was like, man, if people had time machines, everyone says, like, the first thing you do is go back in time and kill Hitler, right? Anyone agree? But I was like, what if Hitler was the one with a time machine and he'd actually gone back to kill someone worse than him? Jews. I'm a little bit. It's all right, I'm like, calm. Jewish. You tell him. Shalom. Yeah, shalom aleichem, mate. That's the other half is Muslim. Yeah. One of the thoughts I was having that really upset her was that I said to her that she was like, what are you thinking? And I said, I don't think a woman will ever land a spaceship on the moon. And she was like, what? That is big. And I was like, no, not because women are bad drivers. There's nothing to crash into on the way. It's not that. It's just that we've had this conversation before. We've all been here, which is like a first woman landing a spaceship on the moon is like, Houston, we've got a problem. And they're like, this is Houston, what's your problem? She's like, nothing. We've been there. I'm like, no, this is Houston, we need to know your problem. But what I'm saying is if you don't even know what's wrong, there's no point even talking about it. You know what I'm saying? So they come back and they go, look, you're very, very close to crashing into the moon. We need to do something about this now. You need to tell me what's going on. She goes, well, it's just now that I've got the space I want, I've noticed there's a lot of distance between us. Yes, sci-fi and bigotry together. A bit of everything tonight. It's not the last time I've upset her. I'm in a bug house at the moment. I was recently caught masturbating over an ex-girlfriend. Oh. I didn't think she'd wake up. I had my first experience at a Chinese hospital recently. Foreigners, have you done the old Chinese hospital tour?
Oh yeah, it's wonderful.
Yeah, it was new to me. It's a very new experience. I'm from Britain. We do the whole, like, I'm here to see the doctor, you just open the door and go in and you're with the doctor. That's the process. In a Beijing hospital, because you don't go to see the doctor, you go to the hospital, you have to do the thing where you like buy the card, show your passport, get the book, go upstairs, check your belly, kick your leg, do a shake, charge your real smooth, pay the doctor, and do all of that. I had no idea that was the process. So I said, where's the doctor's room? The woman went into it, and I just burst in. Pow! And I'm not lying, he was reading a softcore adult magazine. And I was like, what kind of amateur doctor doesn't even have an iPad for this? I'm so unimpressed. And he said to me, oh, you've come in too early. You have to go do the card, the pay, the shake your leg, slide to the left, slide to the right, do the can-can. I did all of that, and I came back to him. And he said to me, so what kind of medicine do you want? We're in an international hospital. You can have Chinese medicine or Western medicine. I did what every proud foreigner in this room would have done. What one's the cheapest? What's the budget, mate? He said to me, Chinese medicine. I said, Ni hao pang yo, let's do this. So he said to me, okay. And he stand up, put your legs side by side like you're riding a horse, bend your leg and stick your tongue out. I went, what? And he went, just what I thought. You're a little fat. And I was like, oh, god damn. He's cracked the case. He said to me, is your job stressful? And I was like, no, I quite enjoy my job. And he's like, really? What do you do for a job? And I said, I'm a comedian. And he went, I've seen your tongue. No, you're not. What kind of voodoo is this? And I said, I promise you, I swear on my mom's life, I'm a comedian. And he went, okay, go on. Move your eyes in different directions and change color. It's a chameleon. He said to me, how much alcohol do you drink a week? And I was like, a lot. I there's no metric, a lot. And he said to me, do you know that one beer is the same as one hamburger? Polish. Really? He said, yeah, one beer is the same as one hamburger. You've got to start making some sensible decisions. I was like, yeah, you do. Right? Absolute liar. He's full of shit. I had 3 Big Macs before I came. I'm still sober. Chinese medicine is absolutely rubbish. Witch doctors. Chinese vets, on the other hand, amazing. Chinese vets are amazing. Give them enough money, they can do anything. They love their job. They're passionate about it. My dog didn't look too well. I was like, I need to take you down. I've been putting it off for too long. We need to get you surgery. I took him in to see the vet. And the vet told me that surgery was going to cost 120,000 RMB. B. I love my dog. It's my fault though, I should have known 8 breast implants cost that much. I love my dog. That was really underwhelming. That's a dog with titties joke, guys. You ain't hearing that anywhere else. That's the best dog with titties joke in the city. I'm holding my own to that one. Anyone done the whole interracial dating or dating people from other countries thing? Just give me a yeah.
Yeah.
I'm dating a girl from Peru. But as soon as I tell someone I'm in an interracial relationship, they think I'm banging a black chick. And that's how I know they watch Pornhub. It's kind of a weird thing. Before I met my girlfriend, I went on my first and last date with an American girl. It was bizarre. We met on Tinder. We did the whole like flirting together, and she said to me, "You're really funny. I like talking to you because you're funny." And in my like man head, it was like, "Be funny all the time. Always make her laugh. She will stay with you." And so I was like making like goofy little jokes. Like we went to a restaurant. And I had a reservation, and the waitress was like, "May I take your name?" And I was like, "As long as you give it back afterwards." I thought I was killing it. I wasn't. But towards the end of the day, we had a bit of banter. There was a bit of flirting, a bit of sort of touching the back of your hands when you talk. And I was like, right, I'm going to seal the deal. I'm going to ask her if she wants to come back to my place. And I was like, so should we go? And she was like, yeah, but there's something I've been meaning to ask you all night. And I was like, okay. And she was like, are you Australian? British? And I was like, holy shit, we matched on Tinder. We've been talking all night. And I was like, why does that matter for your question? And she was like, I'm British. And she was like, oh, British guys don't get circumcised. And I was like, that is an absolute conundrum, because we've been together for like an hour and a half and you couldn't tell where I'm from. The second you get a flash of my nationality, you know what my dick looks like? It's absolutely bizarre. And I was like, wait, so you mean to tell me that all American dudes have been... And she was like, yeah. And I was like, why? And she was like, because it's cleaner. It's clean. And I was like, so is washing twice a day? And like, I don't get it. She was like, actually, it helps prevent the spread of STDs. She was like, if you don't have a foreskin, you can't catch STDs as easily. And I was like, yeah, just take my teeth out. I won't get any cavities. And I pull my eyes out. So I'm shocked. Take that, cataracts. I felt like I was on high ground. I didn't then want to tell her, well, actually, I have been circumcised, which I have. But I didn't want to tell her that now, because I thought she's the bad guy. And I don't want to be like, oh, but actually, I'm changing rules, I think, because it's not sexy, is it? And for me, it was like a surgical procedure, because when I was 6, I had a fully grown penis. When I was 6, my penis was fully grown. It hasn't grown since. I had to have a bit of skin removed. And I didn't know that that was a weird thing. I thought everyone had that until my first day of nursery, or kindergarten, as you guys call it. I was in the bathroom having a little pee. Kid David next to me just looked over and went, your pee-pee looks weird. Now, his is the only other one I've seen. I was like, no, your pee-pee looks weird. It's like a little fleshy elf hat on the end. And he was like, no, your pee-pee looks weird. And he was like, he ran out and was like, Thomas, look at Johnny's pee-pee. It's well weird. Thomas ran in. Now, Thomas is one of them kids. If he tells you to do something, you do it. So he was like, Johnny, show me your pee-pee. And I was like, no, I'm shy. And he was like, show me your pee-pee. And I was like, he was like, your pee-pee looks weird. And I was like, what's your pee-pee look like then? Because I've only seen, I need to see. And he flipped it out. And I was like, wow, 2 fleshy little elf hats. And I was like, that looks soft. Can I touch it? He was like, all right. So I was like, want to have a trade? And he was like, all right. And he was like, oh, my God, it's quite rough. And I was like, yeah. Now, obviously, we've got Americans in the room. You might have gun owners. Sometimes when you're cleaning your gun, it goes off. That's what I'm saying. Got a bit excited. I'm losing you, aren't I? I'm going to cut this story very, very short. Basically, the principal walked in and caught us in the act. She went fucking livid. She called me into her office and fired me from that kindergarten. And that's why I have to do comedy. I've been Johnny Largo. You've been great. Thank you.
pedophile. Yes. Daniel Dan, where are you? No.